Bet Angel, a scene one, a take one. And marker. If you're interested in trading with Bet Angel, then visit our website where you can download a free trial of Bet Angel Professional and Bet Angel Trader. If you want to learn how to use them, then visit the Academy where we give you a detailed, structured walkthrough of each product. And if you're an existing user, then head on over to the forum where we have a load of files for you to download to customize and use within Bet Angel. So there's a feature I would like to show you on Bet Angel. It's only available if you're on version 155 or above. And it will significantly improve your ability to trade using the ladder interface. And this feature is called markers, or they are called markers, I should say. Let's use the plural, should we? Because you are likely to use more than one. So let's explore specifically the concept of this, and then I will actually create one for you. And there are examples that you can download and import into Bet Angel available on the forum. But typically when you're ladder trading, you're looking at all of the information that's in front of you. You're trying to make a decision about what you want to do next. And there's probably information that you could do with right in front of your eyes. So we already have a feature within Bet Angel that can display that information. We have the additional information area on the ladder. You can put it at the top or the bottom, and that will allow you to bring in information specific to the market in which you're trading. That will allow you to actually highlight information that may be of interest to you. So if you're trading football, it could be a goal. If you're trading tennis, it could be the score. If you're trading in horse racing, it could give you information about the volume weighted average price, the current traded price of that favorite, how high it's traded in the last minute and stuff like that. Now, the clever thing with all of these features, markers and the additional information, is that you can create automation to analyze the market and just pump information straight to you on the ladder. So you don't need to guess, you don't need to try and interpret stuff. You can actually create a little bit of automation that will gather some data, do some calculations, and then display it for you. Now, typically you've been able to do that with the additional information area, but we thought, wouldn't it be great if you could actually put that straight on the ladder somehow, highlight certain key points of the market in which you are trading, give you a heads up right in front of the interface that you're actually actively trading on. And that is why we created markers. And the concept behind markers, as the name suggests, is that you can actually put them on the ladder and you can mark different parts of the ladder. So it could be that you put a bar across the ladder, you could highlight just one cell, you could put additional information by creating a marker that's highlighting that specific thing, or you could do more than one. There are lots of different things that you can do. So what we should do is actually demonstrate to you how to set one up, and then I will show you in the background during that process a couple of different things that you can do with markers that you can download and that are available from the forum. So without further ado, let's see how you would actually set up a marker on Bet Angel. So looking at the Bet Angel ladder interface, and this looks exactly the way that you would expect to see it normally. But what we're going to do in this video is we're going to add markers to it. You need to be on version 155 or above of Bet Angel to have this feature, but let's introduce some markers to this particular ladder interface. Now, in order to do that, you need to change the ladder settings. So we have a main settings area up here. I'll just click on that to show you what that is. That shows you all of the settings that you can make within Bet Angel, and there are a load of them. But it also includes information and settings for the ladder. However, you don't have to click on that. What you can actually do is when you're in the ladder tab, you can actually go to the top here and you'll see it's got its own separate ladder settings editor. And that is because there is so much that you can modify in Bet Angel with the ladder interface. So let's click on that and see what settings are available to us. And you can see there are a significant number. It affects the way that the ladder interface is displayed, what information it displays, how the columns are linked up, the markers, which we'll have a look at in a second, the charts you want to use, how you want to display unmatched bets, if you want to display additional information, the display order, and what the enhanced area looks like. But for this video, we're going to be looking at markers. So let me click on markers, and that will immediately introduce you to this particular concept. Now, one of the things that
we're going to do here, because we're going to modify the ladder, you've probably got ladder settings that you're familiar with already. So if I go up here and I put or name this setting that we're going to do markers, I'm going to save that so that we've got that defaulted. Incidentally, make sure that you pin this when you're messing around, because as you move between the ladder and the settings, you may find it loses focus. So make sure that you pin this. But also, what we have to do is make sure that we actually select that from the ladder settings. The concept of having this drop-down box here is that you can actually make the ladder look like anything that you wish. So you can create it to make it look like something you're familiar with. You can modify it to your heart's content. But when you do that, you save it. So you can see here, we've got loads of different examples in here and a few that I've created to use on videos. But because we're working in the markers one that we've just created, that setting up here, we actually want the ladder to be displayed with all of those settings. So we've clicked on here, we've saved or done a save as and called it markers, and then we've selected that from the drop down menu on the ladder interface. So let's look specifically at what markers actually do. So if I click on show markers on the ladder, you can see nothing's displayed, and that is because this particular marker is displaying information at odds of two. So we can see that the favorite and the second favorite are at odds of three. So what we need to do is, if we change that to odds of three, you'll begin to see what a marker does. I'm just going to recenter these ladders by pressing enter. There we go. So you can see the marker is actually highlighting odds of three. And you can do that in a number of different ways. So we're currently using a border at the moment. We could use horizontal bars, we could use vertical bars, or we could do a filled cell if we wanted to. And you've got two different orders of priority here, because if you've got markers working within the same ladder interface, you may want to give one a higher priority over the other, so that one gets displayed on top of the other marker. So that's why we have those options available to you from there. But you can see that you could change the color if you wished to something a bit brighter. I'll choose the horizontal bars for the moment, or shall I? I don't know. Yeah, so many options. But we can change the line width as well. So in fact, maybe I'll just go for a three on here, given the width that I've chosen to display the odds on the ladder. But you can also select what columns that applies to. So we could have it on the trading profit column. We could have it on the bets area. We could have it on the back, the lay, the odds, all manner of different market. In fact, if I just highlight that and cycle through those again, you'll probably be able to see it a little bit better. Trading profit column, bets, the backside, the odds, lay side, the second bet area, traded profit column, estimated position in queue. And you can see there are whole lots of options there, including one that just marks the lot. So you don't have to custom create that. You can just say, just put a line right through the middle of my ladder. But you can also mark the price in a number of different ways as well. So you can do it by a fixed price, because we've just basically said a fixed price of three. Or if you want to, you can do a shared stored value. So basically the concept is you use a piece of automation to create a price, which you then mark on the ladder. So if you're looking for a specific point in the market, using a little bit of maths to do something, or you want to highlight some specific area within the market, say the highest traded price, the lowest traded price, volume weighted average price, pretty much anything that you want to do, stick it into a stored value on the automation or via a servant, and then you can actually display that on the ladder. And you can do that for the selection or for the market or for the actual event itself. So you've got several different options there in terms of what you want to do. And you can also do a historic stored value as well. And that's something that's unique for BetAngel version 155 or above. You can actually store data in an array, in a list, and then you can actually put that value back into the ladder or onto a chart or any number of other things as well within the particular market. So that's very helpful to do as well. But basically you can see you can change the style of the marker, what it looks like, the color, the size, how it's displayed across each of the ladder columns. But you can also choose a fixed price, a stored value, or a historic stored value in order to display that particular type of information. And once you've done that, what you can actually do is you can add additional markers as well. So you're not limited to one. We could actually say, okay, we're going to frame the top and the bottom of the market. We're going to frame a particular point within the market. So if I frame this at 2.5, and because it's at a different area within the market, we'll do it on a different color. So in order that we can actually actively display this, maybe what I'll do here is bring this up to 275, shall we? So you can see you can sort of create traded ranges effectively, or target ranges, or you can do all sorts of clever stuff. The whole concept behind the markers really is to give you a visual aid to information that you may be looking at somewhere else, or information that you may be calculating somewhere else. So the way that I use markers is it aids me in terms of my interpretation of where the market is actively trading at this particular moment in time. What I'll do is I'll download an example for you in a second, and we'll import that, and you can see how it can be used. But yeah, you can add a number of different markers if you wish. You can reorder and prioritize them. You can change how they look, exactly what they do, and you can pull in information from automation if you wish to do so. And once you've done that, you can save that to your ladder settings, and then that will be ready for you to use when you next use BetAngel or on the next market. And maybe you want to switch them on and off. The easy way to do that is to create a ladder profile that has them on and one that has them off, or different versions of the markers if you're trying to look at different things in different sports, perhaps. But fundamentally, that is the key concept behind markers. And what I'll do now is we'll actually have a look at some of them in action. And the example we're going to look at, you can download from the forum. So one of the great things about BetAngel is that you can customize it to your heart's content. You can do so many clever things with it. But of course, there are lots of settings and lots of modifications that you can make. However, in order to help you, we put loads of examples on the forum, and we make it really easy for you to pull those examples into BetAngel to be able to use. And that's exactly the same on markers. So if you have the ladder settings open, you can click on the settings option here, and you can import ladder settings. And we've given you some examples on the forum of a whole variety of different types of ladder settings, including standard ones that just make it look like something you may be familiar with. But also we've done the same for markers, and I've imported some markers, or some examples of markers, into this particular version. Now, once you import them, it will appear on the drop-down list. And then when you actually go to use the ladder, you can just select them from the drop-down list. So you can see at the bottom here, we have the markers one that we saved, but we also now have faded LTP direction and VWAP moving traffic light, which sounds rather interesting. So let's click on those and find out. But these are examples that we've got that you can download, and then you can actually play with them and understand what they do. But if we look at the faded last traded price direction, you can see that this is another indicator giving you a clue as to where the current price activity is and roughly what is going on within that. And if you want to, you can actually go to the markers area and start sort of fiddling around with any of the settings that you have within that particular area. So this will actually highlight where the current last traded price is, but also where the traded price has been. And in order to do that, it actually uses the history list function within the markers. And there is an additional download that you have to do in order to pull in the automation that does this, but again, we've supplied that for you on the forum. It's really easy. You just download those files, import them into BetAngel, and away you go. But basically, it uses the historical stored values to actually look at where the price activity has been in the market, and then it uses the markers to actually plot those on the ladder itself. Now, if we look at the traffic lights as well, you can see this is looking at the volume weighted moving average price, and this is basically showing you where the money has been matched and plotting an average price based around that. That's a really bad description, actually. But if you Google VWAP, you'll be able to understand sort of roughly what the concept is behind that. It's used very commonly in financial markets. And again, if you want to mess around with that, change some of the colors or the way that it is displayed, then that would be very easy to do within the markers area within the ladder settings. But you can basically see we're displaying additional information here right on top of the ladder to give you a clue as to where the current price activity is, or where the VWAP is indicating that maybe the future price activity is within the market. So yeah, well, those are available to download for you to have a play around with, to modify and so on. And then you can choose to integrate those into your existing ladder settings.